Hello, and welcome to this Archer Point presentation on Business Central Connections and Extenders. My name is Alex Wiley. I'm a senior pre-sales consultant here at Archer Point, and I'm going to lead you through this demo today. We wanted to create this video because there are already a lot of videos where people are diving into specific ways that each one of these platforms can be used, but we often hear that users don't know what they don't know. So this is a general overview of a lot of the common tools that are available and connect with Business Central and ways that those can be used. It's also nice because a lot of these are free. So they're already included with your Business Central license, and it's a great way of extending functionality within your organization. So let's go ahead and jump in. First thing we're going to look at is the Business Central phone app. This is free to use. You can download it from the Windows, Google, or iPhone stores. If you're on Business Central SaaS, you log in just like you would with your web client. If you're on-premise, there's a little bit of setup required, but after that, you log in as you normally would. It also mirrors the web client that you have. So I'm going to go ahead and pull over my phone screen here. So this looks very similar to how my role center looks when I log into my web client. It has the same tiles available. If I click the line icon down here, these are my bookmarked areas. And I can still interact with my reports. I still have access to my Power BI reports. I can even click into those and see the detail with the pop-up. And if I go down to my ellipsis in the lower right, I can change the reports that I'm looking at and it refreshes it. So I can see all of this information on the go. Some other common ways that we see users use this are, for example, if you're out visiting a customer and you want to register that interaction, you can open this up and do that directly from your phone. You can also use your speech to text feature. So instead of having to type lots of notes on your keyboard, you can use those same phone features right from within here. Another way we see this being used is the ability to create sales orders. If you have a shop floor or a warehouse and you're working with a customer, you can create a new order, add things to the order as you're talking with them, find items that you need, and then that's going to automatically upload back to Business Central and you can finish processing the order when you get back to your office. The next area is the Business Central Outlook connector. You can enable this within Office 365 or you can download it for your desktop client. It's tied to the customer and vendor information in Business Central. So if you've put the emails for those records in there, when an email comes in, you can click the Business Central button and it will detect the email address and pull up that customer or vendor's relevant information on the right-hand side. You can also use this to edit some of that information that's within Business Central or create new orders. If you create a new order, for example, the Business Central connector can look at the contents of the email, and if they've said, I would like to order item ABC, if that number exists within Business Central, it's going to suggest that item when you go to create the order. So it also can help cut down on the redundancy of having to do additional typing, and you process that order all the way through within Outlook if you like, and that prevents you from having to go back and forth between Outlook and the Business Central client. Next, we're going to go through some of the popular Power Platform applications. The first one is PowerApps. This is a way to easily create low and no code user interfaces. It's popular when you have users that don't normally log in or interact with Business Central, as well as if you need to merge data from other data sources. So you can pull in information from not only Business Central, but other programs as well, and put them all in one place in an interface that makes sense for your users. And it's a fairly simple drag and drop interface. We've got some other videos that you can explore on this and learn a little bit more about creating new interfaces with PowerApps. we have requests for wanting to have customers who are entering one item number, and maybe that's going to multiple places or multiple customers going to different systems. You can use this to put it in one location and then send that out to various other applications. Next area, this is a backbone of a lot of functionality within the PowerApps universe. It basically acts as the engine that reads and writes information to and from different areas. That could be your Business Central database. That could be a Dataverse table. This is where those triggers and that the actual execution of that happens. And one of the main reasons that we see people using PowerAutomate is to extend functionality of approvals. The out-of-the-box Business Central approvals have some limitations, and with PowerAutomate, you can set up multiple conditions for, let's say, if you want different approvals based on someone's sales code to go to different people, you can do that all within PowerAutomate, and you can have those triggers happen in the background only, or you can have it do things like send email notifications. There's a lot of flows and APIs that are set up to work out of the box. So when you go to set one up, you can just type in what you're looking to do. For example, what we see up here when a sales document approval is requested, that's an out of the box flow that's created and is ready to go. And we also have other videos on setting up and using those. Our next area is Dataverse. Dataverse is a flexible data management tool. So this can scale to any size. You can use it for creating data lakes. You can use it for managing cubes. You can use it for reporting. You can use it to merge data from a lot of different points throughout an organization, a lot of different systems, spreadsheets. You can put all of those in one place. And there's a lot of layers of security that go along with this. So you can have organizational based control to the data, which makes it very easy to create and share that information and know that only the people accessing it have permissions to access and edit. The next area is Power Virtual Agents. Virtual agents are chatbots, which are set up by the user and you use prompts. And this is similar to if you've called into an automated line before and it's asking, what can we help you with? This is the same thing, except it's all text-based, and this can read and write information. So for example, if someone is on your site and they're trying to enter contact information, you can get prompts and then create that contact as a prospect in your system for a salesperson to follow up with. Or you can use it, like in this example, we've used it to request how much of a certain item is in stock. And this is a really good way to reduce the amount of time that people like CSRs spend on the phone and on email answering the same questions all the time. What's my order status? What's my confirmation number? Those are all things that can be answered with a virtual agent. And the back end of this is using PowerAutomate. That's where all those triggers happen. So let's look at one example of how you can combine actions across Power Platform. So in step one, a user creates a new item in Business Central, and then we have another user, let's say someone in engineering who doesn't need access to Business Central, and they then can go into Power Apps and upload CAD or additional details to that. And when the item is submitted, someone will get a notification via email through PowerAutomate, and someone can directly from their email approve that item to go in, and then the approved item has its CAD information stored in Dataverse, and then only the relevant information that's needed can then be copied back into Business Central. So there's a lot of ways that various systems can be tied together. It could even go to an external system. You know, this is a good way of linking things. Like if you have an external CRM system, there's multiple layers of approvals and back and forth that can happen all with these low no-code solutions without having to create custom portals, creating custom APIs, or anything like that. And the last one is the Business Central Web Services. If you do have to create a custom solution, if you're going to get custom development for specific portals or linking to external websites, other applications, You can always use the out-of-the-box web services to expose the objects that are in Business Central, and then write your JSON AL-related code and call those to link to those custom applications. And our last piece here is just a note on the permissions and data security. When you're accessing Business Central through PowerApps or these external sources, the security and the permissions remain the same. You do have to take into consideration things like if you're using one of the data connectors or a web service, then that web service is its own user, so you want to only give it the permissions that you would grant anyone who's using that connection to look at it. But if you are, for example, opening up something with Power BI or Power Automate, and a user is using that to access Business Central, it's going to use the same license and the same connection, so they can't look at things like human resource records that you might have for employees or sensitive financial information unless they have access to that in Business Central already. And with that, that's our presentation. Thank you. If you have any questions about what you've seen today, please reach out to us or leave a comment and let us know. Thank you.
Thank you for watching this Archer Point video. Stay in the know with the latest on Microsoft Dynamics by subscribing to our channel. You can also learn more from our blog at archerpoint.com or email info@archerpoint.com to contact us. See you in the next video.